Hello guys, it's Mungai Eve. Tuko hapa, bado tuko Mombasa, tuko Nyali. Ni ukweli? Ngati, tuko Nyali? Why are you laughing? Nakuuliza. Okay, yeah, tuko Nyali. Leo tumepatana huyu kijana guy. This is an amazing handsome young boy. Anafanya vizuri sana. Mi sijui kama mnaweza bake vizuri venye ana bake. Not necessarily kubake peke yake, anafanya a lot of stuffs. Anaitwa Budding Chef Eric, right? Yeah. Ebu ambi your name.
Hello, I'm Budding Chef Eric and I'm glad to be here today.
Exactly. Actually, kuhadi na YouTube channel, guy. Mimi at his age, sijui nilikuwa nafanya nini. How old are you?
I'm 12.
You're 12? Yeah. Just 12?
Just 12 years old.
Wow. Ebu tuambie, when did you learn to cook so well, baking, vitu kama hizo?
It's a long story actually. Started when I was 5. The passion was sparked by my mom who used to
5 years?
Yes, 5 years old. Hey. I think I even have a photo.
Mm-hmm.
We started baking two small cakes that we'd have for breakfast, mm-hmm. up in the evening on Sunday. And just pole, I grew an interest and I began to love it. I delayed it for a while I was from class 1 to 3. But the moment I got to class 4, I don't know what happened, the interest sparked again and I started baking.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever been into a baking school, maybe a cakes?
I did 2 courses at Valentine Cake House. Mm-hmm. Each was a week long. And now I was able to gain experience on decorating cakes, which I had some troubles with.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so the knowledge that you have in baking, is it from school or mazingine you've done research?
What I know today,
mm-hmm.
10% I got from my mom, 20% from the classes, and the remaining 70% was online, YouTube, places like that. That's why I have a YouTube channel to help you learn how to bake, because most of these things I don't think you can learn
in class.
In a class, yeah.
Okay. Ebu tuambia, apart from baking, do you like cook chapatis, some other things, some other type of food? Do you cook?
There are a few other things that I know how to cook. Mm-hmm. Lakini I know for sure chapati imenishinda kabisa.
Inakauka ama?
Inakauka. It's usually crunchy. That's why mom, when I cook chapati, she'll be able to tell, yo, Erica amepika.
Okay, ebu niambie, which other food that can you prepare? You're able to prepare?
I'm able to prepare shawarma.
What's that?
Chicken shawarma, in Nairobi. So it's just pita bread with some marinated chicken, some coleslaw. It's really nice. Now that you're in Mombasa, there are some nice places up here. You need to go and try shawarma. It's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
So do simple soups, dinner rolls. Mm-hmm. Yani vitu tu kiposh posh za dinner. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wow. And what do your parents say about you and baking? Unajua si kitu ya kawaida, especially for he kukua yeye all the time ako kitchen anatafutana na hizo mayai apike.
My parents have absolutely no problem with this. They've been supporting me from day one.
Yeah,
it's just been a great journey. I'm grateful to my parents for investing the skill in me kwenda kununua mayai last minute to siku niko na order ya asubuhi.
Oh, you actually get orders?
Yes.
I thought you just cook for yourself and for the family.
I know. I also do sell cakes. If you're in Mombasa, I have delivery all across Mombasa available for you. Mm. I do cakes, I do cupcakes,
mm-hmm.
and a few other things to loaf cakes like banana bread, carrot cake. So yani tu vitu poa poa. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, utatupia samples za picha zenye ushai kufanya tuweke hapa waone when you doing an amazing job.
Yes.
Ebu tuambie, who motivates you kwa hii industry ya baking, hii industry ya chef?
Hii industry ya chef. Yani my biggest inspiration until currently today as we speak,
mm-hmm.
is Nick Giovanni. He does great cooking. He was a contestant on MasterChef. And also Morgan Hipworth, I think, mm-hmm. Hipworth, something like that. He's an Australian baker. He does donuts. He has his own shop.
Mm-hmm.
He's my inspiration to start even selling my cakes.
Mm-hmm.
The guy is 60, I think he's 21,
mm-hmm.
and he owns his very own shop in the streets of Australia. And that is my dream one day.
Wow, that's so amazing, guy. You, apart from wewe kukua a great chef, you're very, very intelligent. I just love that.
Thank
Ebu
you.
Tuambie, When did you start selling cakes? When did you decide that I want to be baking my own cakes? I want to be baking cakes for our family. I'll start selling them right now.
I started my course. This was 2017, that key December holiday. I started taking to small orders. That got my first order. It was just a simple and vanilla cake. I did small orders of loaf cakes, 1 kg, what. I have a few photos of my first cakes.
Mm.
And then later on, I went ahead and did that course because I wanted to learn how do you decorate those birthday cakes. Because, it's also because nanishinda.
And right now, can you decorate a birthday cake?
Right now I can decorate.
You know, I need a YouTube cake. Have you ever seen a YouTube cake?
Yes, I have seen them. They're very popular and... I would love to make that for you.
Yeah, I need one when I get to 100K. 100K. Yeah, and I'm almost there. So you're going to bake one for me?
I will surely.
How will I get it when I go back to Nairobi?
I'll take a photo and send it na WhatsApp. Takula kwa macho.
I thought kuna venye unaweza nitumanishia. Hakuna. Right now una deal tu na Mombasa.
Una deal tu na Mombasa.
But you can bake it then I come back and take it.
Yeah, you can. Yeah.
Okay. Hebu tell us by the umesema ulikuwa unafanya classes za bake za hizi kupika.
Yeah.
Na bado you're still in school,
yes,
right?
Yeah.
How are you balancing both of them?
Balancing school and kupika of course has been a challenge. Now that I'm taking on orders, but it's become easier and easier for me to balance over the time. At first, I was like a really intelligent student. I've been able to keep that up mpaka leo.
Mm.
But I set aside time where it's just for reading books. There's a week I say no more orders. And I think that's able to help me relax. Also, relax my brain so that I'm able to move with more creative ideas.
Mm.
Because when unafika mahali, you've taken up so many orders. That sort of, creativeness to come up with a new cake design in Aisha. So you just take time for yourself. Sit down, read books, get back on track with classes in case you're behind. And it just works great for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So you're just good in class.
Yeah, the teachers are very good in class.
The teachers are not complaining.
They're not complaining.
Okay. What about your parents? Has there ever been a case where they said that you will stop baking because you've not been attending to your chores, maybe other chores like cleaning the house?
Yeah, they've threatened me quite a number of times because sometimes they get slightly out of hand.
Mm.
There's a time now, that we are now online classes. Sometimes I would also now mix the classes, just switch off my mic, run downstairs, finish an order. Then I started to fail. And my parents were like, if you don't pass these exams, never bake again in your life.
Mm.
I felt so threatened.
Mm.
I left. I quit on all of my orders that I had for that month and focused on those exams.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, what about your chores, your house chores?
Chores, I do them very well. Of course, lazima ni skume kidogo. Otherwise, yeah.
Okay, Eric, where do you get the cash to get some, you need some ungas, you need the salt, you need, like, what do we call them? Is it to zakutayarisha? We call them what?
Ingredients.
Exactly, the ingredients. Where do you get the cash from?
At start, even now, I'm relying on my parents and also the money that I get from my orders.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. And how did you get to learn about the recipes that you need for a particular cake? Maybe I need a vanilla cake. I know there are various cakes. How did you get to know about the recipes that you're supposed to use?
I started off with the best recipe of my mom. Of course, my mom never used to wear nile kuchota na kuweka kwa kwanini una mix tu unaendelea nayo. But with them as I grew interest, I started to learn off of YouTube and just use the method that my mom would use, but just in more precise nini. Been able to recipe test most of my recipes. Some have failed, some have succeeded. And the recipes that I share on my YouTube channel are some that I've tested and will ensure you success if you try and make them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. What are some of the challenges that you've come across in doing your job?
Hey, the problems, there are a few of them here and there. The first problem was when my hand mixer broke down. I had to use a whisk for a while. It was really terrible. Of course, ni arm workout, but at some point it got really frustrating. Also, when it comes to agreeing with my parents on how to balance school and baking, that also becomes an issue. And also when the cake decides to go sideways. Yeah, so
kuna sometimes kuna beki inaenda ovo inakuwa vibaya.
Let me tell you a story. Last year I tried to make myself a nice two-tier birthday cake. So I baked the cakes. I didn't even tell my parents I was making myself my own cake. I baked the cakes. When I went to put them in the freezer to chill, the cake, the smaller cake, it just fell right onto my shirt and onto the floor. I cried for the rest of the day.
By the way, juwewe kwanza we ni mfupi, so kufikia freezer na kwa ni ngumu.
Yeah, that's why the cake just slipped and fell onto my shirt and onto the ground.
Okay, what about when you're baking? Have you ever baked a cake and then it backfired?
It has backfired quite a number of times. At the time I made a red velvet cake, a while back, I forgot to put baking powder. The cake never rose. It was gummy. It was disgusting. We even had to throw it out.
Hii inakuwa ni hasara.
Hii inakuwa hasara pia, yeah. It was for an order.
Okay. Like, how did people know that you can bake and started making orders for the cakes?
Mom would just take photos of what I was making, and people in church. My first order was from a lady in church. We were coming from church that Sunday, and she was like, "Eric,
how
I want
that?
A cake."
This year,
this is 2017 December, that holiday. That's when I said I just started selling cakes. People were like, "Eric, I need a cake." Like, mom took a photo, she posted it on Facebook. Someone else came, "Eric, I also need a cake." Na pole pole, people started making more and more orders. And I've been able to taking orders for the last, I think, 3 or 4 years.
Okay, approximately how many orders do you get per month?
Per month depends on the month. There are months where pin drop, silence, snow orders, I get frustrated. I start to think, honestly, Eric, what have you done? Why are people not placing any orders? And then, like, this month, these last 2 months, I've been very busy. I've been getting order after order. After a long time of silence, in the January that my mom was talking about.
Okay.
No one placed orders, but
I love you. Pia minaonanga, like, most people are wanakuanga na bad days from April. Months, but yeah. January,
there are less and less people who have birthdays.
Okay, per day, how many cakes can you bake?
Per day, I like to stick with 1 or 2 cakes per day. If it's simple cupcakes, yeah, I can do 3 orders. Like in Isle, decorated cakes, I try to stick 1 or 2.
Which is the biggest, like in kgs? See, cakes dinakwanga in kgs.
They're kind of kgs. For now, the biggest I can do is 2 kgs. I once tried to do 3, 2.5, didn't go exactly to plan. So I was like, for now I just stick to 2, 2 to 1 kilos.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's so amazing. If I may ask, unajua clients wanakuanga always right. Have you ever made a cake, umepelekea mtu anakuambia haikuwa exactly what I expected?
Not exactly. Of course, if you order from a 12-year-old, you don't exactly have high expectations. I've never had a client, by the way, say that the cake was not nice. If the cake was not nice, obviously, watanyamasa hawatasema kitu.
Especially coming from a kid.
Especially coming from a kid. And then, of course, they'll ghost me and never say anything ever again or place an order. Yeah.
Okay, have you ever maybe baked a cake for someone, then akapotea kabisa? Shall it happen?
Akapotea. Yeah, this is the lady I made for cupcakes. Lord have mercy. She's a nice lady. She called me, she found me on Google. She was like, "Eric, I need some orange cupcakes. I'll come and pick them on Sunday." This is Saturday in the afternoon. I'm like, you know what? Excited. First order in a while. Ikakimbia kitchen. Ikazitengeneza. I iced them. I decorated them. Ikazeka kwa fridge. Ikampia. And I was like, you know what? Your cupcakes are ready. She was like, okay. Ntazikujia. Next day, she had not come for them. I called her again. Hello, are you coming? Akasema, yeah, ntazikujia. I've been a little bit busy. Over and over. Time. Ikapita. After 3 days, I called her again. She never picked. And she's never picked my calls ever again. Eddie had to eat the cupcakes and he was happy to do so.
Okay. What do you think was the problem with the lady?
I think, you know, Ile, you just place an order maybe to support this kid and then you realize you don't need them anymore.
You change mind?
You just change your mind.
Okay. Yeah. Me, I would love, ukifanya, wewe unafanyanga order zako aje, uchukwangi deposit kwanza.
So there are few cakes that I take deposit, especially if it's a cake that's above 2 kilos. If the cake is 2 kilos at least, mm-hmm. you'll have to pay half of it up front, mm-hmm. yeah, so that I can get started with the order.
Mm.
Otherwise, usually, nakupikia keki. And most of my customers are loyal. Keki kimaliza, nitamwambia, nitamtumia picha. They'll pay and then mm-hmm. they either come pick it up or I offer delivery services.
Okay. And how do you deal with cooking without eating? Unajua mimi venye napenda keki, naweza pika nipate nishakula zote by the time namalizia.
I sina hiyo issue. I think I have a little bit of, you know.
Mm.
Yeah, cause cake stop being very sweet to me and ile kitu yenye nakulanga once in a while.
Yeah.
Because they are all around me, so yeah, you can just kind of guess get used to
na
it.
Pia hiyo harufu ni kama chapo. Ukipika a lot of chapatis, you don't take a lot of them.
Yeah.
Okay. Nini nyingine? Tuanze. Okay, what, Eric, what are you going to prepare for us today? I can see you have some ingredients here.
So today I'm going to prepare for you guys some red velvet cupcakes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Me, I have never taken them. I just love you make it so fast so that I can taste.
Yes, they will be done in half a minute.
In half a minute?
No, that's just an expression.
Okay. You said you're going to prepare what?
Some red velvet cupcakes.
Red velvet cupcakes. Yeah. What do we need to come up with them?
So for this recipe, you need some eggs.
How many?
Mayai mbili hapa. Red food coloring. Hii ni za 10 bob tu utapata dukani. Sukari, blue band, unga, cocoa powder. Don't use drinking chocolate. Cocoa powder. This one doesn't have any sugar in it.
Mm-hmm.
Some vanilla, baking soda, baking powder, na maziwa mala.
Oh, maziwa mala kiasi inatoshana vile.
2 tablespoons hapa.
Okay.
Yeah.
So guys, the cupcakes are ready. Ama ni aje, Eric?
Yeah, they're ready. We've done, they've baked, they've cooled, and now we are ready to decorate them.
How long does it take for them to get ready?
Yani ku bake, it's just about 15 minutes. Doesn't take all too long because they are fairly small. Like, you have to let them fully cool. I recommend up to 30 minutes just for them to cool before you decorate. Otherwise, if you put icing on top of hot cupcakes, it will just melt and not very, look very nice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now you're going to decorate them, right?
Yes.
Okay, get started.
So here I have them 12. I have them on a cake board and on a turntable. Mm-hmm. I have my icing here in a bag with a tip.
Mm-hmm.
I'll sacrifice one to decorate the tops, but let's get started.
We are done.
And they're done. That's exactly how you decorate some simple red velvet cupcakes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are there other type of cupcakes?
Yeah, there's so many different types of cupcakes. There are vanilla, chocolate, marble, rainbow, Oreo is actually a really nice flavor. Chocolate and so many other different flavors.
Okay, for us to achieve this, how much do we need for everything?
For everything, like cost wise, Ama?
Mm.
Cost wise, I usually charge $550 for a pack of 12.
Mm-hmm.
Just come delivered to your door. This is accounting for the ingredients, the labor, of course, the amenities like the oven, electricity, the board, the bags, the icing. Total, that usually comes up to $550.
Okay, that's so amazing.
Yeah.
Where can people get you?
People, you can find me over on Instagram at Budding Chef Eric, Facebook, same Budding Chef Eric, and especially on YouTube, Budding Chef Eric. I have so many tutorials up there that can help you get started, whether you're a beginner, you're intermediate. Yeah, they're great recipes for everyone.
How long have you been doing it on YouTube?
I've been doing YouTube since end of December last year.
Mm-hmm. Who helps you with the shooting?
Kevin of King Kid Photography.
Mm-hmm.
Does all of my videos. He does an amazing job. And I love how they all turn out.
Okay. Now they are ready. We can even take them.
You can even take them.
Okay, we're going to taste after this. Guys, meanwhile, you subscribe to Eric's YouTube channel. He's doing an amazing work at a very tiny age. You support him. You place some orders. Senior Kevin, I'm a size you na soma.
Placing the orders, I'm all for them.
Okay, remind them your YouTube channel.
It's Budding Chef Eric.
Meanwhile guys, you subscribe, we like, you share. Sisi mtuache hapa tujibambe.